Hey, so this is a guide on building on FLEEK with ENS domains. So a few things just to start out. I am Dylan, satoshi.testaccount.eth. You can find me on Twitter in general. I'm around. But to start out, we've done some different spaces and webinars on how to use FLEEK and ENS and IPFS. IPFS is the interplanetary file system. So if you go to IPFS, .io, you can see that this is a site that powers the distributed web, peer-to-peer protocol for hosting files, things of that nature. FLEEK allows you to utilize IPFS in a much easier way. It's going to allow you to build websites and apps on it, permissionless, trustless. It utilizes IPFS to actually deploy these things. IPFS is the raw protocol for the file system itself. It also utilizes IPNS, kind of like ENS, but IPNS is the naming system for IPFS. And we'll get into why that's important, why that matters in general. But just to start off in general, IPFS powers the distributed web. In that sense, this is where you will actually store your files for your site or your app, and this will be distributed across the web and will tie into ENS. So we don't need IPFS directly right now, so let's close that out. And the domain that we're going to be doing this through today is testdomain.eth. So right off the bat, you can see there's nothing set. Only thing that's set is me as the registrant, me as the controller, and my resolver address is here as well. There's no content record set, not set. So this is important. This is actually the record that will be set and changed to host your IPNS information, which points to the files that we're going to be uploading. So to start out, what you need to do is go to GitHub. So if you don't have a GitHub account, get a GitHub account. And what you'll do is you can see I have a few repositories now, like my first website, some other registrar templates and things. But here's where we'll get started. So when you get started with your GitHub account, immediately do a new repository. You can name it whatever you want. We'll name it ENS-test domain. And you can choose it whether or not it's public or private. So I'm going to choose private. We'll scroll down. You don't need to add a README file if you don't want to. None of this will really, matter unless you want to tell if you have a certain license for your code. You just go to create repository once you've chosen the name and if it's public or not. And straight from here, some quick setup tips. Now you can use the desktop app or whatnot, but it's not necessarily important for what we're doing today. So to get started, we're going to just upload an existing file. So here is where if you have content, a website, index.html, whatever, if you have a Web 2 website, source code, etc., a template, whatever, this is where you will use that data and upload it to your GitHub, and it would then be transferred to FLEEK here in a moment. But let's get started with this. So we've made our GitHub repository. It's available and ready for the files to be uploaded. So here I am. I have my files, Dylan ENS Cloud website files. So within it, you can see I have a README index. I have an index page itself. I have some JS JavaScript elements that this has code to reference. I have some source images. I have some font files, and I have some CSS elements for the page design itself. But you don't need all of this. This is just addition that I have in my index page. You could use just the index page itself. It would be fine. It would render the same way for a static page, but I have some different ones here just to show you as an example. So we'll take both of these right here and actually drag and drop them right into GitHub. So you can see two files just uploaded now. I'm going to take all of these folders right here, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to grab them and drag them right across. So all of these files are now being uploaded as well. So we'll wait here for a moment for them to finish uploading to my repository on GitHub. And once it's fully uploaded, you'll see here in a moment, we got about half the files left. All of them are going to the GitHub account in that repository. So here we are, 85 files are ready. We scroll all the way down to the bottom, and you will see commit changes. So commit changes, what this does is saying, yes, I want these files to be uploaded to my repository. So it's processing the files for a moment. So wait for them to get done. Once complete, we will immediately go back to Fleek. So this is really it as far as GitHub is concerned, getting started. You'll take your content in your GitHub account, upload it to a repository, and once it's available and in your account, once you know that it's right here, it's in your main, all your files are in the main branch, you'll go to Fleek, and that's where you'll get started for free. So build on the new internet. That's what we're going to do. So get started for free. We go to it. It comes up to the page to sign in, and you can sign in with your Git provider. This is where you'll sign in with the GitHub account that you just created and used to upload the files. So you're almost there, you know, already. So sign in with your GitHub account. Press it here. It already knows me and trusts me. So here it is signing me into GitHub. And here we are. So the app page will load up here in a moment. And you'll see right off the bat, I have some already deployed. These are already deployed sites. You won't have this, but you'll have the button to add a new site. So add a new site. It's going to ask you, you know, from zero to hero, three easy steps. It really is. So you've already signed into GitHub. You've already uploaded your files to GitHub. This is where you'll now connect with GitHub. Right here after you've clicked Added Site. And here is where we've created the domain for ENS-test domain. So you'll only have one to start out unless you've used GitHub for other things. But you only have the one that you just recently uploaded. So look for the named one, ENS-test domain, pressed on it here, and this is where we'll choose where we want to deploy it. We're using IPFS. So continue. All of this content is really irrelevant for what we need, so you don't have to interact with that. Deploy site. And here we go. Site deployment is in progress. You can watch it down here below. The deploy log. All of it's working right here on your behalf. You do not have to go through and do anything. You're really essentially 60% done at this point. You've already taken your content from GitHub, uploaded it to GitHub, etc. You have now logged into Fleek, pointed that repository to your Fleek account, and connected all of it together. And you've chosen to deploy that content and those files to IPFS, the Interplanetary File System. So now it has gone from raw hosting through GitHub and is now being distributed out and deployed on IPFS network and nodes. And here we are. It's now ready. So we can now visit the site. This is pre-ENS right now. This is just on IPFS. So we're going to verify on IPFS. And let's wait here for a moment for it to load. And here it is. ENS Decentralized Web Hosting example. This is the website in this raw form through IPFS. It's hosted. It's a full website. All of this here, ENS, was made to make your life easy. Here it is, smart web hosting. This is all things I've made. Here's my Twitter account. You know, I got some information here. Our company, Cleverline, you know. I have an NFT source embedded. You know, there's different reactive parts to this. Business stats, you can have all this. You can have your friends on here. Anything you want. You can go down, testimonials. Keep on going down. You have a contact form. All of this can be responsive. And here it goes back to my Twitter, backlinks and things like that. This is a live website right now, live. So here it is on IPFS. If you say, okay, well, this is great. I want to share this with everybody, but I want it to be tied to my domain, my ENS domain. How do I do that? So let's keep going. So here we are. We know it's all set. We know this website's live. We just checked it out and everything. It's on IPFS. So we'll close that out. Let's go back to Fleek. So here we are through Fleek. We'll go down to the settings itself. All of it's ready. So now let's go down back to deploys. And you can see under deploys, this is where it shows this was published. So if we go to overview and click add custom domain. Let's see. Build and deploy here. Domain management. So under domain management in settings here on your Fleek domain that you've just deployed, settings, domain management, ENS. So under ENS, once you've deployed it on IPFS using Fleek, you can now add ENS to your Fleek site. So it's really, in my eyes, the other way around. You're integrating Fleek to ENS because ENS is the one at the very end of the chain getting all this data. It's a pointer, essentially, but We continue here at ENS. This is going to want to confirm that we are the controller of this domain. So with that being said, you do not have to be the registrant to be the controller. With that being also said, if you have a subdomain assigned to you or given to you, you are more than likely the controller. You just need to make sure you're the controller of this domain for you to be able to set this record. So it's going to check me here in one moment. So test domain.eth. It's going to verify. OXA7, that is me. So yes, add ENS. And what this has given me, it has now generated a link for me to set the content hash. This will set that hash record we were talking about previously. This is the content record that is will now utilize and set on our behalf. You do not have to do it here. You can do it right from Fleek. So let's go back, click set content hash. Step one, set content hash. Set the content hash of your ENS domain, and we will automatically update the site for all future site deployments. This operation is only performed once. This is great because what Fleek does for you, any changes you do in GitHub, let's say you change the title or a picture or whatnot in GitHub, those changes are looked at in GitHub by Fleek. Fleek takes those changes and pushes them back to IPFS and automatically utilizes IPNS so that you don't have to change that hash, content hash, over and over again. It's automatic. So we want that. So let's set the content hash. It's going to choose what wallet we want. I'm using MetaMask. And it will pop up the notification and the transaction right here. So it's right here. $7.80. Confirm it. We wait here for a moment. And what we've done is taken our GitHub repository, connected it to Fleek. Fleek has deployed it to IPFS. It is now utilizing IPNS to tie that record into a never-changing link that will be tied to our ENS profile. All of the changes are automatically synced, and within moments here, we'll have testdomain.eth fully live. So what we can do from here, this is the domain itself. IPNS is set. Let's go to it. So what you can see here is from the domain, now there's a content hash set. There's that IPNS record we were talking about. But if you see, HTTPS testdomain.eth.link. So if we press that one time, what's currently occurring is all of this data is now being sent through all the CDNs and whatnot, and it's going across the web. So this is saying, you know, a link record being set. So it's populating. But if you go to testdomain.eth.limo, this is an alternate CDN. Here we go. So you have a couple choices with this. As it being a decentralized network and a decentralized hosting, there's different CDNs that will host these names and contents for you. So if one's down, there's another one available. But this is just one example. .limo seems to be one of the fastest. .link is also a concept that you can use. But if you've seen earlier, I used it with just the .eth itself. And that's because I have MetaMask installed in the browser. But if you see here, here is the site we were just looking at on IPFS, now hosted through this site. It's fully secured, SSL is in place, it's on my website, and the same one, .link, we go to it now, you know, within moments, see it's still, you know, taking those records and uploading them, but it's occurred on .limo already. So as a whole, on the decentralized CDN side of things, it now is going out. And you can see here, still pending on one, pending on another. But all of this is being synced out across many, many CDNs. And that's really it. We have deployed this through IPFS. Here it is on IPFS. We have tied it to the ENS domain. Here it is, one-to-one. And the content records have been set. IPNS, nothing will change in that sense. So if I were to make any changes, if I go here to the images on my upload, and I were to, let's say, delete one of these, if I were to go here and delete one or make a change and upload one, I could immediately go back to Fleek, and under deploys, these changes would automatically be checked, and this would go to out of date, and the new one would be pushed automatically. And this would just immediately start resolving, and it would all remain the same. So it's pretty straightforward. It's pretty exciting to have. I'll be releasing some more templates and things like that that'll allow you to build off of it. But if you have some index pages right now, you remember, go to GitHub, upload them, go to Fleek, select them, deploy them. Once you can verify it on IPFS, you can then go to Settings, Domain Management, ENS, and then, boom, tie your ENS domain into it. And then within moments, this site becomes real. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed.